Good morning, children. This is 5th standard English class. Today we are going to start with a new block, block number 6. No ordinary soldier. No ordinary soldier. It is a story, children. You are going to read the story by yourself. Our main topic in this lesson, what I am going to teach in this block is elements of a story. What I am going to teach? Elements of a story. So today in this elements of a story, our topic is word maps. Word maps. Here I wrote few keywords. Let me explain you the keywords first. Impressive. What do you mean by the word impressive, children? Impressive means, for example, if you go to any shopping mall to buy any, to purchase any dress, as you go, if you find any dress nice, you'll be impressed by seeing that dress and you'll purchase that dress. Right? I hope you understood what is impressive. Aware. Aware means to get an idea of one particular thing if you are thinking about. Next, coming to word map. Word map, I will show you how to use word map. Synonym. Synonym means meaning. That is similar meaning. Antonym. Antonym means opposites. Okay. This is the word map, children. In keywords, we have seen the word map, right? This is the word map. How to write word map for one word? Here I took the word impressive. What is the word I took? Impressive. And in the lesson, where can you find this word? If you open your reader, this is the first page of the lesson. This is the first page of the lesson. So, in which page of the lesson you have? Page 1. And where is this impressive word? You have to search where is the word impressive. Can you see over here impressive? Yes. And in the third column of the word map, you are going to write this sentence. He was tall and impressive with a thick mustache and a deep voice. Okay. This sentence you are going to write over here. See here, they have given the heading sentence from story. Where this impressive word is used in the reader, that sentence you are going to write. Then from here I am going to the next, that is dictionary meaning. Dictionary meaning, that means one meaning I wrote from the dictionary, that is something that causes admiration. Next, followed by a synonym, that is meaning. Another similar meaning we have to write for the word impressive. That is notable. Okay. Next, followed by antonym. Ordinary. Antonym means it is opposite, you have to write. Ordinary. Followed by your own sentence. Here you are going to write your own sentence. That is, the king looked royal and impressive in his purple robe. Next, followed by other forms of the word. Now this impressive, what are the other forms to write the impressive? That is impress and impression. Okay. So this is the word map for the word impressive. Now open your workbook. We are going to write workbook.
Block 6, S1. S1 word maps. As you open, write the date 28/9/2020. See the first question over here. Fill in the word map for the words. Here they have given the word incident. Okay. Now what you are going to do first? I have explained you word map, right? What you are going to do? You are going to search this word in reader and write the page number, sentence from the story. We are going to write dictionary meaning, similar meaning, one opposite, your own sentence and other forms of incident. Okay. Open your reader, children. Just now I have explained you about impressive. This is the first page of the story. Now, what word he had given in the workbook? Incident. Now see, where is the word incident? Yes. This is in which page of the lesson? This is the first page of the lesson. This is the first page of the lesson. and this is the second page of the lesson. So we are going to write here page number 2 and the sentence from the story. This is the sentence which is there in the story, children. It seemed they were lucky, comma, but that changed after a strange incident one night. We'll check this in the reader. See here. It seemed they were lucky, comma, but that changed after a strange incident one night. So this here I wrote the sentence from the story, followed by dictionary meaning, children. An event that happened, followed by similar meaning. Synonym means another meaning, similar meaning. Event, E-V-E-N-T, event, okay. Next, antonym. Antonym means opposite. For this incident or event, we don't have any opposite word, children. So I wrote, this noun does not have an antonym. This noun does not have an antonym. Why? Because this is an event, right? Next, I wrote my own sentence for this incident word, children. I read about a strange incident on the internet today. Other forms of the word is incidentally. Incidentally. Coming to the next word, children. Next word, they have given incident. So, cut that word incident because it is a repeated word. Write frantic. Now, where is this frantic word in the reader? Can you see over here? Frantic, F-R-A-N-T-I-C. So, in which page this is? This is the first page of the lesson, second page of the lesson and third page of the lesson. So I wrote over here page number 3. Okay. Now sentence from this story. As the jeeps neared the bridge, comma, the soldiers heard loud and frantic noises. See here, the same sentence is over here in the reader. As the jeeps neared the bridge, comma, the soldiers heard loud and frantic noises. Okay. Now, followed by dictionary meaning. Wild or out of control due to fear, anxiety or stress. Okay. And what is the similar meaning for this? Synonym. Similar meaning for this is worried. What is the antonym, that is opposite for frantic? Calm. And here I wrote my own sentence. The parents became frantic when they could not find their daughter in the crowd. Once again I am reading. The parents became frantic when they could not find their daughter in the crowd. What are the other forms to write frantic? Frantically. Okay. So by this I have completed S1, children. I want you to complete S1. Read the lesson and write keywords, make sentences and meanings in classwork. Don't forget, draw the margins properly. Write the date. Block one on the red margin. In the middle line, you are going to write the lesson name, No Ordinary Soldier. And then you are going to start with bit number 1, keywords, underline the heading, leave one line for each word and complete. After completing keywords, draw a line with color pencil, write bit number 2, meanings, leave one line and complete your meanings. Then draw a line with color pencil, write the heading bit number 3, make sentences. Underline the heading with color pencil, leave one line and write make sentences. I hope everything is clear now, children. Right? So what you are going to do, you are going to read the lesson, complete your classwork. Meanwhile, you are going to complete S1. Okay? Is it clear, children? Hope you all understood how to write word map also. So by this, our session ends, children. Meet you in the next session, Elements of Realistic Fiction. Thank you.